Gary Walsh kicking it out. One back there by Barry Cunningham. Left-footed forward towards Manus Boyle. Can they kill it off here with a goal? They're satisfied with a point. Well, he's happy to just put that further bit of the distance between the sides.
Great ball in from Barry Cunningham to Manus Boyle in behind. And even though he could see John O'Leary, he does the right thing. There's no point in taking a shot and maybe missing the goal and giving Dublin a breakdown field. Very clever play by Manus Boyle.
High ball taken in quickly into Paul Clark. And again, the great combined work of the Donegal team denying Dublin. That was Joyce McMullen, a little annoyed with the way the pass went astray and gave possession right back to Dublin. Tommy Carr. Fed inside towards Jack Sheedy. Donegal back there en masse, missed it out, won there, big cheer from the Donegal following, but lost. And it's Vinnie Murphy going in, and somehow the goalkeeper conspires to deny him. But look at the number of Donegal players back there in front of their goal area as Vinnie Murphy was trying to cut through. Great work by Gary Walsh. It's Paul Clark kicking. And he's put it high and over the bar.
Again, a wise decision by Paul Clark to take the point. It leaves only one score in it again.
On my watch, 2 minutes to go. 17 points for Donegal, 14 for Dublin. Gary Walsh. An important kick out, this one. Possession of vital at midfield. It's won by Barry Cunningham. Knocked off his stride, however, by Paul Curran, but they keep the tempo of the game going and hold up the point of the attack with Martin McHugh going forward, raiding there against Keith Barr. Nicely back in again, across towards Declan Bonner, standing his ground, miscuing somewhat, however, and John O'Leary able to make the catch, but he was pushed out over the end line. The umpire is signalling a 45. John O'Leary feeling that, yes indeed, the referee has ruled it out and said it was a foul, not a 45. A good decision, I think. Joyce McMullen. Is this to be it for Donegal? It would be a victory that would put a great deal of heart to so many counties around the country. Bonner has put it over. 4 points for Declan Bonner. And Donegal look to be on their way to their very first championship victory. Sam Maguire looks to be booked for Donegal for the next 12 months. Deegan and Dublin needing a goal urgently now. Phelan dropping it down towards Vinnie Murphy. Murphy feeding it inside towards Niall Guidon. Guidon dancing round the challenge of Donald Reid, tripped however, and it's going to be a free kick on the 20-metre line, taken quickly inside to Jack Sheedy. Sheedy still advancing, they need the goal, they get nothing. He's kicked it wide. Dublin with 8 wides in all, 6 of them in the second half, 9 wides for Donegal, but only 2 in the second half. We're in injury time. Donegal poised. Well, who would have thought it at the start of the championship? Yes, you'd fancy them to do well in Ulster, but to go the whole way. Well, there were people who said only the traditional winning counties, the Kerrys, the Meads, the Corks and so on, were likely to win, and Dublin as well. Martin McHugh there, anxious for the full-time whistle, and it's over! And Donegal has won the All-Ireland final! They win by 4 points! A tremendous contribution by Manus Boyle with 9. Declan Bonner with 4. The man directing operations, Martin McHugh, got 3. The team captain, Anthony Molloy, gave a stirring performance in midfield. Their backs were quite superb. And it's a win that will thrill Gaelic fans, I'm sure, throughout the country. No disrespect to Dublin, but this will do a lot for Gaelic football. It will do a lot for the so-called weaker...